This is the first in a series of Agilent instructional videos to help you maintain the best performance from your ICP-OES. We'll begin with problem diagnosis. Analysts report three main topics of concern in ICP-OES, namely sensitivity, precision, and accuracy. These topics of concern are affected by three areas within your instrument: sample introduction, optimization, and standard and sample prep. Let's see how everything relates to each other. First, we'll break down sample introduction and optimization. If we look at the components in sample introduction, you can see issues with your nebulizer can affect sensitivity, precision, and accuracy. The same applies for your pump tubing. We can also see that the spray chamber and torch injector can affect sensitivity and precision. Memory effects can also affect precision and accuracy. The preparation of your calibration blank and standards, as well as your samples, is very important for achieving good sensitivity, accuracy, and precision. Look out for high readings for the calibration blank, which could indicate reagent contamination. Memory effects or carryover can be minimized by ensuring adequate rinse times. Use only deionized water and high purity acids, standards, internal standards, and ionization suppressants. Preparation of blanks, standards, and samples affects accuracy in a variety of ways. Verify that digestion is complete with no particles in solution. Finally, for optimal accuracy, always try to matrix match your calibration standards to your samples. Most instrument failures occur in the sample introduction area, so that's where you should start your problem diagnosis. Setting up some routine or preventative maintenance procedures can prevent problems occurring in the first place. There are some general do's and don'ts in using an ICP-OES. For example, verify performance before analysis by checking nebulizer uptake, peristaltic pump tubing, and the blank reading to ensure there is no carryover from a previous analysis. Be sure to rinse between samples and at the end of the run. The rinse solution should match the sample matrix. Clean the torch and nebulizer regularly and inspect the condition of the nebulizer tip. Finally, follow analytical recommendations in your user's manual. There's a similar list of don'ts. Don't assume your system is still optimized or that the nebulizer flow rate is the same. Don't over-tighten the pressure bar or use a simple water blank. And don't wait until you have a blockage before cleaning. These simple steps can prevent problems from mounting up. Please see the other videos in this series where we talk specifically about nebulizers, spray chambers, and torches, and learn more about what you can do to ensure your ICP-OES always operates at peak performance.